As Japan rushes to contain the stricken Fukushima Daiichi power plant, radioactive particles have already contaminated tap water as far as 250 kilometers away in Tokyo. This has prompted countries including the US, Australia, and also Singapore to ban food imports such as milk and seafood from areas near the power plant and even outside the affected areas of Chiba and Ehime Prefecture. Japanese restaurants are bracing themselves for the shortage of supplies and looking for alternatives. At least one Japanese restaurant has suffered a massive hit. Inagiku at Fairmont Hotel saw a drastic 40% drop in business. The high-end Japanese restaurant imports its seafood items like scallop and prawns from Iwate and Miyagi Prefecture, which were wrecked by the natural disasters.
Any of your customers voice their concerns about the food that they are having at your restaurant?
Actually, these past few days, we got many inquiry about our food is safe or not. So we always answer our product is now getting from the Kyushu and Kansai region, and it is confirmed it's all a safety. And we also try to shift some possible product, not only from Japan, also from the other country like Australia and New Zealand. It's quite a similar season. They have like a four season.
For Mr. Sanu, who prides himself in bringing authentic Japanese ingredients to the restaurant, he admits that it was a painful decision to switch to supplies from other countries. But he says the drop in business has less to do with the fear of radioactive contamination than the fact that many of his regular customers are Japanese businessmen who are now busy attending to their affected businesses in Japan. Sakae Sushi, that has 37 outlets in Singapore, has not seen a noticeable drop in business. The sushi chain imports 20% of their food supplies from parts of Japan not affected by the radiation leak. It is also looking to New Zealand and Canada for alternative supplies. Genki Sushi, on the other hand, has little to worry as the restaurant located at Orchard Central does not import its ingredients from northern Japan. Singaporeans Razor TV spoke to are cautious about the food they eat but are not overly fearful.
Of course, a little bit cautious. Yeah, and having read today that even the contamination, I mean that the food exported to Taiwan also has a little bit contamination here and there, we of course try to, for me, I try to learn a little bit more.
Actually, I think the radiation levels when it concerns to the marine life, I think it's not very high. So I think it's actually a safe level. And I mean, like the government is also doing checks on food that's imported from Japan. So I think, yeah, I think it's quite safe.
Based on, you know, the strict regulations they have in Singapore concerning food inspection, I trust that, you know, whatever's coming in should be safe, radiation safe, hopefully.
Have you gone to a Japanese restaurant after the disaster hit?
Yeah, I certainly have.
The Agri-Food and Veterinary Authority of Singapore has reassured Singaporeans that checks will be conducted on all food imports from Japan. Concerns over contamination has also fueled the debate on the use of nuclear energy and whether Singapore intends to harness nuclear energy in the future. In the next clip, we ask Singaporeans to weigh in on the issue.